Damn, I'm freaking Giants next. Damn, that league. Damn, I thought I freaking had a break from playing computer, one of the user game. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today, trying to push their team to victory. It's Bridgewater's Browns going up against Palmer's Dolphins. Excuse me. With that, let's head on down to Miami, where we'll hand it over to the two men calling our game. Okay, you're what? Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Thank you, Larry. It is a hot and humid afternoon as we get set for football in the southern part of the Sunshine State in Miami, Florida. Today, it's week three, and we've got see if this works right away. Between the Cleveland Browns and the Miami Dolphins. Charles the lone setback. They go play action here on first down. He's got Travis Benjamin complete. And all the way in. Touchdown.
I love that play.
His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Browns have taken the early lead.
Happens every time to some I play somebody.
The football to start the game and score it. And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible?
Oh my god, I pressed X in the fucking green. Wow. Also, it registers there, but on a field goal, don't register. What the fuck?
On the return, it's Brandon Tate.
I hate this height. I wish they had a new old field goal thing, but the right hand of the six is so much better. I hate that. I fucking zoom in. I can't figure out how to get off it now. 16 yards there. And the Dolphins have a first down. Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I'll be getting much more balance. There we go. Big time run. Big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good. And no escaping this time as he'll go down.
You probably did a halfback swing play. You probably did a halfback. I do that every, I have that in my playbook too. Wow, I can figure how your quarterback went out, or your quarterback of the year. God damn it, I can't figure out how to get this unzoomed. What the fuck?
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones up to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
He finds Douglas complete. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route where the receiver worked the defensive back inside and then broke back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation on the break from inside to outside. He threw the football. As the receiver turned around, the ball greeted him. Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Now Palmer to
throw.
Jermaine
incurs his second touchdown on the season. Now the Dolphins have tied it. Now they can take the lead with the extra point. And this one from the uprights and good. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now the Browns coming out on the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going.
Yard that now.
See if it's that easy here. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
Bridgewater now on second down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland.
That ain't the same play.
His third touchdown now on the year.
No, the other one's a play action.
The Browns are back in front. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run back of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big time play for a touchdown.
I'm like, seriously, I pressed X. Wow.
Short boot,
I'm tired of this fucking kicking thing. Fuck. I wish they put it back in there. Someone's watching it. Don't know. They don't tell me who until he comments. If he comments at all.
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Two people watching it.
Let's go, let's go. On second down, Palmer. And this one caught by Delaney Walker. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually
makes you
to play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space.
Doing the same play too, is what you talk about. That's
they'll throw on first down here with Palmer. That is caught in the seven. They'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Jermaine Kearse, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. Now the Dolphins have tied it. Now they can take
running in the kicker, roughing the kicker.
So the flag is for roughing the kicker, a big 15-yard penalty.
And I'm not sure that was the time to go all out after the kicker. Plenty of time left in this game.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now
where's your freaking
last time they
one
out,
thing?
They scored. Still
there it is. There's a fight one.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
We always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller just looks.
How the fuck can you let that go off your hand?
Yards runs and goes to one of those.
Back with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gaunton. The Browns with a football to begin. able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Off the play fake, Bridgewater. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. And give him a gain of 37.
Trying to defend a drag route is really tough because you don't want to jump a route that's shorter or underneath as the drag route is too quickly, because oftentimes they want to run that route and then hit over the top of you for bigger yardage. So if you can chip off the timing of the receiver off the line of scrimmage so he can't actually get into the route, that's the best way to defend it. But there was no possibility of that on that play. End result, receiver won it a big way.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. A couple of Dolphins in on the stop.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Rob Gronkowski, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Browns have retaken the lead. And they will line up now for the two-point try.
Let's go!
Bridgewater will try and throw. And that is caught for the 2 points. And, of course, on the two-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
It felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver, ball's put on him, 2 points for them.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pat McAfee to kick. And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And they're hoping to capture some of the...
God, this is going to be a high-scoring game. None of us can stop each other.
Because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to and what plays they want to put together.
Damn it.
They've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard. Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands.
You ain't fooling me. You can say all you want.
Now Palmer, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is...
This is probably going to backfire me, but I'm going to do it anyway.
Targets Delanie Walker, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up a fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and that just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. They'll stop troops. They're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. Well, here we go on fourth down. Palmer. This is caught by James.
Damn it.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Thank you.
You ready?
Vantaio not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Surprised AJ that you got better. Way sounds.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Now Palmer on third and long. It's caught on the left side by Kurz. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Come on. Well, it's second quarter, so.
Field goal would have been
come
a
on.
Decent
come
lead
on.
55 yards and keep the kicking unit on the side.
This is what I need. If I stop you, I'm good.
They're going on fourth down. It's Palmer.
What the? Wow.
14 yards there on the pick.
He had to throw it quick, you little.
The conversion here on fourth down. Fresh set of downs here.
Get ready.
Now Palmer on first down. And this one caught. Season and the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Tucker now to add the point after.
He actually went for field goal. He took him a while to pick up field goal.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Let's just feel it at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Damn it. Oh, well. I'll run this. So no one running, but run it.
The confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
That confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again.
Fuck you, holding.
What the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around.
But at least it's only 10 yards from the spot of the foul, so.
The D-line's going to spread out.
That's 5 yards.
Here's Bridgewater. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. Call it a gain of 3. And it'll be second and 12. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be a
runner. That is him.
What the? Oh, my God. Seriously, I passed the ball, and you fucking did that. They need to fix that in the fucking game. Yeah, but I press freaking triangle to get rid of it, and no motion if I could throw it.
Let's field it at the 2. And
But gets me more annoyed of it.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they had the fumble last time.
Fucking.
Led to a touchdown.
That's annoying. Oh my god. Irritates me.
Big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Throwing again. Bridgewater on second and 10. Eluding the pressure right. Into a double team and it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. So after the interception, here's Palmer. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away, and it's second down. Second down now after the incompletion.
Check three. Let's go.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. And this is caught by Curse. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And now the Browns are going to take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. Trying to force it to his tight end, Walker, and it's intercepted. Then it's Ha-Ha Clinton Dix with a pick. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
They want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. How about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come up and put a hit on him, do they?
Bridgewater. It's complete right side to Benjamin. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Going for the deep ball. They were trying to get it there to Michael Floyd. And that'll bring up second.
Thank you.
Some changes here as the D-line separates some.
Oh, fuck, only one playing. One. No, we're running now.
He's going to try and go deep again. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense.
Not one.
It ended in a big drop.
Play action now. Bridgewater.
See, I pressed before you got to me. What the fuck? Irritates me.
Always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's when it fit that.
They're indeed going for it. Bridgewater. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher.
Because I'll just do this.
And the Dolphins get the football in great field position. And out come the Dolphins now. And this is a spot late in the clock near midfield, though. Maybe take a couple chances, see if you get in field goal range.
You do that if you have trust. And this should be a position now for the great ones. They relish this opportunity to try to put points on the board. Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch you should have made. Second and 10 now, and it's Palmer. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one, they were just unable to complete the pass.
On third down, Palmer. This is caught by Jackson. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. First down coming there on the intermediate passing play. That's been a point of emphasis, they told us in practice, using those medium routes to keep the defense off balance.
It wasn't just them telling us. We got to watch them practice it and work on it because they've been trying to fine-tune it and get it right before this game. I think they have to be happy with the result.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Let's go, let's go.
Again, it's Palmer. And that is incomplete. Stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down.
Incomplete pass, too. I didn't know freaking. I thought you freaking got the ball.
It's right down the middle, and that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So they get the three, increase their lead to close out the half.
Excellent way to end a drive. Going to the locker room with a little bit of extra momentum.
Taking the South African on the road.
Three to their total.
Field it about a yard deep. Yeah, they'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you up to Orlando. And with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Larry Ridley. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the Dolphins are going to recover. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know, the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot.
A face mask. Whatever.
And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
They come out here in the eye. Throwing down, Palmer on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Now Palmer to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of
He ain't getting nowhere this time.
So used to seeing those big guys make big time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the veteran Cortland Finnegan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that.
Ted Ginn's going to go. He's at the 50, 30, 10, 5, and all the way.
Yes.
So from back deep, deep in their own territory, all the way into the end zone. Do you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure.
Seriously, I pressed. Oh my God, I hit the field goal.
There, right? Taking a chance because the normal call is the
ball, be safe.
Instead, they put
it. See, I'm. I pressed X again. And ain't registering the fucking button. I registered the second hit, but not the freaking first time I pressed it. Fucking annoying.
They get sent to take over here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here with my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit. You stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you stop the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding the clock. Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. But for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That would be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Hoping for there as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know, they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
true. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
On second down, Jamal Charles. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And Ginn's got it. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. We saw five receivers out there. Third down from that distance. You had to think quick pass. They were able to get it done.
No doubt about it. Everything went quickly on that play. The processing, getting the ball out, getting it to the proper target, and picking up the first down. Hard to defend. Maybe your only hope is get your hands in the passing lane on the pass rush and try and bat it away.
Again, it's Charles. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Ndamukong Suh makes the tackle.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for it.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Bridgewater now on second down.
You son of a bitch!
It's intercepted. It's the linebacker, DeMarcus Ware. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll come out in the pistol. On second down, Peterson. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with 3rd and 1. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or creep or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Give him 6 yards and they do convert on 3rd. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. They run again with Peterson. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. That's what they needed. It's an 8-yard gain, and now 3rd and 4 suddenly doesn't look so bad. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football. It's also Dolphin lead to begin quarter number 4.
I know I was gonna pick that. I figured trying to tackle you.
Remember the good part, forget get the bat.
I like that even better. That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
The first down carry here for Charles. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. J.J. Watt, the one that gets him down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Now a play fake here on first down.
No! No! God damn it!
David Harris. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. So now here come the Dolphins. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of going, oh man, I can't throw four.
Son of a bitch!
What do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three. Do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. 10 yards still left on second down.
Man, it pisses me off now.
On second down, here's Palmer. Right side caught by Jackson. A good pickup there. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. He's in alone in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there. Ha-ha, Clinton Dix there for the stop. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
It's a smart football, but you know the defense has
God
to know it
damn
as
it.
Well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that load in the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9.
And now the Browns are going to take another timeout. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the 2-minute warning. And we'll be back. Conclusion after this. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Here comes the D swarming to the line. First down, here's a run with Peterson. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Another tote for the workhorse here this afternoon. Peterson, they got two of the three they needed there. It leaves them with third and just a yard.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Palmer will throw. He's got Curse. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here. That pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the deep.
And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Adrian Peterson, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. You can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now the Browns offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Caught on the left side by Benjamin. They'll get 19 yards there, and it's good enough for a Cleveland first down. And they're going to go soft on the corners. First down, Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Ted Ginn. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Browns have cut it back within a score. Bridgewater will try and throw. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points. It gets it back within a field goal. So a minute and change to go, and this is going to be an onside kick. Dolphins are going to recover. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best.
Of course you are taking
me. Get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was a
you take the cheap way out. I hate people that way. Cheater.
Kneel and call it a day.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Come on there, take the chicken cheap way out.
Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here.
Come on. You gotta throw the ball, you little wimp.
6 yards to go here on second down.
Should just punt the ball.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in.
Ooh, I'll just keep doing this. Just keep your time on the clock.
Second and very short here, less than a yard. Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the... So the offense has it first and 10. They come out here in the eye. Oh, Palmer looking to throw. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points they clicking on.
But feel great about it.